morning, Joe.
This is your medicine, Joe.
Ready?
Open up.
You gotta let it all in at once. Go. Oh, yummy. Good boy.
So I told you all that I would give you an update on my toilet after I've used it for a while. And so today is toilet cleaning day. We've already emptied it out. And then I cleaned it out with some Clorox wipes. And now we're gonna fill it back up with this aspen bedding. And it works really good. I was actually surprised on how well it maintained smell. I was really worried about, you know, my home smelling like a toilet, but it's good for about 4 or 5 days, depending on a lot of things, as you can imagine. But about 4 or 5 days for one person before I am changing this stuff out. Cleaning out the sea head is a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. Honestly, I was very worried about, like, how messy it was going to be to change out that compost medium in the back. And I really wanted to take the time and use it for a little bit before I give you guys a review because I want it to be real and honest. I was really, really concerned with the fact that you, like, you know, poop into this compost medium and then you turn it and it just kind of like spins it around in this compost medium. And I was really worried about, you know, poop getting all over the bucket because you're like just spinning it, right? But what it does is it like churns it and like brings it into the compost, and so it does not get on the walls. I was very shocked the first time that I cleaned it out. I was like, oh, this must be a fluke. But this is the second time that I've cleaned it out, and I'm just shocked at how clean it is. I mean, I even took the disinfecting wipes, the Clorox wipes, and wiped all around the inside, and there was no poop on the rag. So I am just very shocked. I am very happy with my purchase. It is a very expensive bucket, you know? So I was very worried, you know, that it was going to smell really bad and it was going to be really gross to have to clean out. But that's not the case. It's a very easy. You literally just take the bucket and you dump it into a bag, or if you're somewhere where you can dig a hole and bury it, or if you are actually composting things. And so honestly, this is the least stinky situation that I've had since I've been on the road in 2020. So I'm very happy with my purchase. Like I said, it is not a very cheap toilet, but it is worth every penny in my eyes, honestly. And the fact that it took, you know, a good 4 or 5 days for me to even notice a smell coming from it, amazing. Amazing. Because it'll last, I mean, that bag of composting material is going to last me a long time. It's amazing. I'm just very happy with it. Very happy with it. It changed so many things. Like before, I couldn't go somewhere if I wasn't able to set up my privacy tent outside. And I did have a little portable toilet that I did, you know, in emergencies set up in the minivan, but it was so sketchy. I was so worried about like an accident happening of like the bag spilling or like having a leak in it or me standing up and knocking over the toilet. Like, I was very genuinely worried about it. And so it was very only emergencies would that ever happen. But setting up, okay, like we had like 20 mile per hour winds the other day. I would not have had a privacy tent. And then I would have been totally screwed. So I'm just so happy that I don't have to do that anymore because it was such a hassle. It was such a hassle that I dealt with for 2 years. And I'm just, oh, it is such a game changer. And I'm so happy with my purchase. And I wanted to share it with you guys and be real with you guys because, you know, this is the best method that I've done so far. And I am very happy with it. And I can never imagine going back to having a privacy tent that I would have to set up and take down every single time that I went somewhere. Oh, it is so nice. It also like opens up my, you know, options of where I can go because of that. Oh, it's great. So that's my little update on my Seahead toilet. I do have a link for it in the description box, but I'm not affiliated in any way. It's just a really great toilet. So I don't know if you guys can see, my laptop is right here. I just finished editing. It was exporting my video, and then I'm gonna upload it. I'm gonna eat some brunch. It's like brunch time now, and then I have to shower. But yeah, we're just chilling today. It's supposed to be windy today again, which is pretty typical for the Southwest. Oh, another update that I forgot to mention, because it was, you know, dealing with rust, so we didn't really get to it, but my awning broke already, and I'm very upset about it. So when I set it up in Maxwell, New Mexico, it was like super still wind, so there was no wind, and I set it up, and it was up for maybe like 15 minutes. This is only like the third time I've ever put it up, and a gust of wind came and it like flipped it up and over, and so like the bars that like the poles go into are all jacked up now. And I mean, I'm still probably gonna be able to like put it up, but yeah, it's definitely like the bar thing is broken now, and so I'm hoping that I can find somebody in Quartzsite who is handy that might be able to help me figure out how to fix that part, because like where it came, like if these were the poles and like this is the back of it and they just went like this, and so this part right here is like broke off, like the screw came out and everything, so it's fine, it's like all rolled up and secured onto the side of my van, but I'm scared to like try to take it out and put it up again because I don't want it to like break further. So hopefully when I get to Quartzsite, you know, I can find somebody handy who might be able to help me fix my awning. Oh, it was just such a bummer because I just got it. It was such a hassle to put on, and I've only used it a few times, and it's not good. Oh yeah, what a bummer. So those are my little updates and my little review on my Seahead. I'm gonna wait for this to finish exporting and get it uploaded and eat. All right, we're cooking in the van today because we're having 20 mile per hour winds and it's really hard to cook anything out there. So I'm making some cauliflower, which is steaming up right now. And we're gonna add in these yakisoba noodles when we're done. They're teriyaki flavored. They come in different flavors, like the hot and spicy ones, but they're really hot and spicy. Teriyaki is my favorite. They also have like a ginger soy, but teriyaki is definitely the way to go. After mentioning that I was getting a compostable toilet on my YouTube channel, I had a lot of people give me advice and like tips and tricks to make it smell less bad, especially the urine section of it, because eventually it does start to get a smell, right? And so one of the things that I found online was an all-natural disinfectant. And so really it's just isopropyl alcohol, and then you do about like, I don't know, they said around 25%, and then add water to dilute that, and then you can add any essential oils that you want to make it smell nice. So I'm using patchouli and ylang ylang. So then every single time after I go pee, I spray this down the pee diverter and kind of clean it off. You can also spray this around the toilet seat and clean it that way. And it makes it smell really nice. And then also it doesn't smell like pee. So it is a very big help. So whoever told me to look this up, thank you. I forget who it was now, but it was very helpful. It helps so much, and it smells really good. I was actually very shocked. It has not smelled like pee yet, and I've been using this same bottle. I spray it very generously, and it's been over a month now. So this is what I use, and it works out really well. I don't know if you guys can relate to this, but I wanted to shower and wash my hair. Realized that all the rest of my clean towels are still in my clean laundry from days ago that I have not put away. I'm sure a lot of people can relate to that. Admit it, you guys. We all have like that chair in our house after you do laundry that you put your clean laundry on and it just sits there for days. It's the same thing when you live in a van, I swear. So much better after I shower. I don't wash my hair that often because I don't want to lose my color, but I use one of these almost every single day. These are just like body wipes. It's like a shower in a bag kind of thing, and they're big. I'll show you guys. They're like made for bodies. In between like having a real shower, like a real hot shower, I use one of these bad boys. Look how big they are. And they smell nice, but not like overpowering with perfumes. It's just fresh, you know? So I'm gonna wash my body down, and you guys can't be there for that. So see you later. Well, now you guys know how I stay clean on the road. Definitely a huge advocate for the shower wipes. These are Pipa Mint. I don't know. I found them on Amazon, and I can put a link below in the description box for them. But you can find shower wipes pretty much anywhere. I know that most places will have them in the like adult diaper section because they're more targeted towards elderly people who have a hard time bathing themselves. But they work wonders. They are so much better than a baby wipe, and I used baby wipes religiously until this like most recent time coming out, and now I don't want to ever go back because they're just larger and like they're more made for like bathing instead of just like wiping. I don't know how to explain that, but
They're just so much better. Yes, that is my new shower routine. I know I've made one here on YouTube before, but it was so long ago, and I had my privacy tent and a little fold-out toilet, and just so much has changed, and I would not go back if I never had to. I would never go back to having the privacy tent. I love my toilet. Like I was telling you guys earlier when I was kind of giving you a little review of it, I will never go back. Now that I've done all of my chores, I am hungry and I'm going to make some dinner. I told you guys earlier I'm going to make that just egg along with some of this Light Life bacon, vegan bacon. It's really good. It's one of the better vegan bacons that I've tried, and also some toast to put it on. I don't know. I'm feeling breakfast for dinner today. So that's what we're going to do. The rest of my night after eating is going to be just packing up and organizing, getting ready to go into town tomorrow because I forgot a couple things while I was in town. My mind was pretty scattered with Joey, and you know, it's been a couple days since we've been to the vet, and he pooped today, which was very exciting because he hadn't pooped in 2 days. So that was something I was really worried about, and he's eating just fine again, and I'm just, you know, I'm so happy that we decided to go to the vet and he's feeling better because it was really worrisome. I was really scared, like something was really wrong with him. I'm just so happy that he's feeling better. So I think this is where I'm going to end this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, definitely subscribe below. I'll also put a link for my Patreon in the description box in case you're interested in checking that out and helping support my channel. Otherwise, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!